Hi guys, Adish Ji here from PureCast 9, and today I'm going to present to you the latest rumors we have surrounding the iPhone 8 due to be launched in 2017. So if you guys haven't realized already, 2017 is going to mark the 10th year anniversary of Apple's iPhone. The first iPhone was launched in 2007. So this being its 10th year, Apple surely has some big plans and big changes planned for the iPhone 8. One of the main reasons why iPhone 8 is going to be a game changer as far as Apple is concerned, if you think about all the designs starting from the iPhone 6 up to the iPhone 7 Plus, the 6, the 6S, the 6S Plus, the 7 and 7 Plus, they all look the same. Except for the iPhone 7s having a different position for the antenna bands and the dual camera on the iPhone 7 Plus. So nothing really has changed apart from their chip and the dual camera. Now, a phone isn't just about its camera and its positioning of the antenna bands, of course. It's the entire experience, especially it's the look. I mean, that's the first thing you go for. You know an iPhone is an iPhone because of how it looks, and you know how a Samsung phone looks. So with the iPhone 8, there are going to be some remarkable changes in design as well as display as well. So before we begin, let me just say that the rumors you're about to hear are what I think the iPhone 8 is going to bring to the table, as well as what Min-Chi Kuo, who is KGI Securities analyst and the most famous leaker of rumors regarding the iPhone, because if you don't know already, he was the one who gave you the most precise leaks and rumors pertaining to the iPhone 6, the 6S, the 6S Plus, the iPhone 7 and 7 Plus. So you get the idea. He is unparalleled when it comes to these leaks. So without further ado, let's get straight into number one. So Min-Chi Kuo suggests that the iPhone 8 is going to have three variants. The iPhone 8, the regular version and the smaller one, the iPhone 8S and the iPhone 8S Plus. Now, obviously, the 8S and the 8S Plus could have different names, but let's just go with the 8S and 8S Plus for now, so that we get a better understanding of what differentiates these variants. So the base model for the iPhone, which is going to be the iPhone 8, is going to have a TFT LCD display that we've already been used to. So the Retina display, in other words. The iPhone 8S is also going to have the TFT LCD display. But the iPhone 8S Plus is where things get really interesting, because for the first time, and let's hope this is true, iPhone is going to bring its OLED panels to the market. So the iPhone 8S Plus could have Apple's very first OLED display. And on top of that, it could have curved displays. So it's going to have curved edges like we've seen with the Galaxy S series. And this is going to be very new to Apple, and I can't wait to see what they do with it. But for all of you who are also thinking that with the curved display and with the OLED displays, they're also going to have the optical fingerprint scanner, which is that they're going to remove the home button altogether. Well, that is still under speculation, because that might not really happen with the iPhone 8 as such, because, well, rumor suggests that Apple doesn't quite have the technology ready for the iPhone 8 having a home button embedded directly into the display, as we're hearing about the Galaxy S8. So we'll actually have to wait a little longer till we get more solid evidence that that's the case with the iPhone 8. But, well, nonetheless, an OLED display. I mean, how long have we been waiting for the OLED displays? I mean, we've been getting kind of bored with the design and the display of the iPhone. They're good, but, well, comparing them to Samsung's Galaxy S series, their flagship models having their Super AMOLED displays with their 2K displays, hands down, I would personally prefer the AMOLED displays. So Apple bringing that to their iPhone 8, go for it. Now, the dual camera is going to make its way to the top model among these three variants. So the iPhone 8S Plus, or the 8 Plus, whatever they're going to call it, is going to have the dual camera, and it's going to have the OLED display. And they are also planning to have some augmented reality stuff with that. We don't know what they're going to call it or what's going to really happen, but something to do with the augmented reality is going to make its way to the iPhone 8 as well. Hopefully all three variants. Now, as for the screen size, it's going to be bumped up to a 5 inch from a 4.7 inch and a 5.8 inch from a 5.5 inch. So the 5.8 inch is obviously going to be the top model, the iPhone 8s Plus with the OLED display. But if you're expecting a 2K resolution, doubtful. 4K out of the question, that's not what Apple is going to go for. 2K could still make its way, but I think they'll stick to the same resolution as we've seen with the iPhone 7 and 7 Plus. So what's good and what's bad about having three variants? Well, the good news is that you get three variants to choose from. So if you want a compact model, you go with their base model. If you want something a little bigger, you go with the model in between. And if you want it all, and if you have the cash, you go for the iPhone 8s Plus with the OLED display. Now the bad. Well, no Apple product is cheap. So I think this gives you an idea of just how expensive their iPhone 8s Plus is going to be. So it might reach the $850 or $900 mark. So that's going to be really expensive. And most of us will probably kind of get alienated from the whole flagship model and we'll probably settle and make a sacrifice and go for the iPhone 8 or the 8s. So that's the good and bad, but hey, let's just wait for it to actually come out and then we'll make a choice. So as for the rumors of the iPhone 8, that's what we have till now. As new stuff come up, I will present them to you, of course. No need to worry about that. All you need to do in between is hit like on this video, subscribe to PureCast9 if you haven't already, and I'll catch you guys in the next one. Cheers. Hi guys, RSG here from PureCast9. What is this?